To backup and restore ProCare data, you can use the built-in Database Backup and Restore feature under the Utilities menu. This feature will not be available if you're on a data-hosted version of ProCare or if you have ProCare installed to your own SQL server. Let's take a look. At the Database Backup tab, we can manually make a backup by simply clicking the Backup button. It'll remind us when we made our last backup. I'll go ahead and say yes, and in a few moments, we'll have a manually made backup. So the backup was successful, and now it's asking me if I would like to copy the new backup offline, which simply means to another location. I could save it in a folder somewhere, or maybe to a USB drive. I'm going to go ahead and say yes, and then I can browse to any location I'd like. I'm going to choose Drive E, which is my USB drive. Say OK, and the backup file will now be copied over to my USB drive. Once the backup has been copied to my offline location, I just say OK. Now I can take a look at recent backups on the Archive and Restore tab at the top. ProCare will store up to 7 recent backups based on a certain formula. The 3 most recent backups you have made will be stored, as well as up to 4 additional backups that are at least 1 week apart. That way you can always get back to a backup several weeks ago if you needed to. Now, you can do a couple of things from this screen. One is that you could choose to restore one of the backups on this list. For example, if I wanted to go back to a backup made on July 14th, I could select it right here and then click the Restore button. Be aware that when you restore the database, it restores everything. So for example, if you had multiple locations using ProCare, this would restore the data for all locations back to the state it was in at the time the backup was originally made. A couple of other things you could do. You could choose to save this backup to an offline location. Let's say I had forgotten to do that at the time I originally made the backup, or I just wanted to come in here for some reason and copy a particular backup to another location. Another thing you can do is choose to recover a backup. If there was a backup you wanted to restore that wasn't one of the 7 listed here, you could choose Recover Backup, and when you do that, you would then have the option to browse to a location where your backup may be stored. For example, I could browse to my Drive E and choose a ProCare PCD file, which is the ProCare database backup file, from my location, and then I would just click Open. In this case, I'm just going to click Cancel, and we'll say OK. But that would have added that item to my archive list. I could then make sure it was selected and go to Restore to get that one restored. Now, another thing you may wish to do is to schedule your backups so that they occur automatically. You can check the little box here that says Enable Backup Schedule, and then you can choose which days you want the backup to be made. You might just say weekdays, for example, and then enter a time that you want the backup to run. This just needs to be a time that the computer would normally be turned on. If for some reason the computer is off at the time you have scheduled, obviously the backup would not be able to be made then. However, the next time you turn the computer on, it will attempt to make the backup. Now, scheduled backups are always made in the background, meaning you don't see it happen. You don't get any messages on screen whether or not they did happen. So just something to keep in mind. And even though we're storing a backup that's made every day, if we go to our archive and restore list, we'll still have a maximum of 7 backups here. Again, our 3 most recent, plus progressively older ones. And that's the basic idea to how to use the backup and restore feature in ProCare.